بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. A great to all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all with our small booklet, Al-Dalil Al-Ilmi, inshallah, for Sheikh Sadhan. And this is going to be a segment number 5, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. من أسباب محبة الله تعالى, means and ways and reasons that we can achieve the love of Almighty Allah. So as we see from this chapter, that is focusing about ways and means that by doing it we can achieve the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in actuality, the Sheikh had made a footnote here and said, مُلَخَّصًا مِنْ كَلَامِ ابْنِ الْقَيِّمِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ فِي مَدَارِجِ السَّالِكِينَ, that this is something that he summarized and took it out of the book by Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, rahmatullahi alayhi, his book called مَدَارِجِ السَّالِكِينَ. So, number one, recitation, قِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ بِالتَّدَبُّرِ, recitation of the Quran al-Kareem with thinking and reflecting. Recitation, reading the Quran with tafakkur, with tadabbur, with thinking, with trying to understand and reflecting in what you reciting. Number two, التقرب إلى الله بالنوافل, getting closer to Allah with optional deed, optional deed from salah, optional deed from sadaqat, optional deed from fasting, optional deed in hajj, all the obligatory things that Allah made it, that he found that there is a means that you can do more. You are obligated, as example, to make hajj once in your lifetime, but you can go again for umrah and again for a hajj, and you continue doing like this. You make salat al-zuhr, you can make 2-4 rak'at after it. You fast Ramadan, so you can go for optional fasting 6 days after Ramadan, Monday and Thursday. So there is a lot of voluntarily deeds that we can do, so it can bring us closer to Allah, that we can achieve the love of Allah. Number three, دوام ذكر الله تعالى على كل حال باللسان والقلب والعمل والحال. Continuing remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, with all means, with your tongue, with your heart, with your action, and with all means available to you. Always to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Allah with your tongue, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. This is remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remembering Allah, thinking and reflecting on the creation of Allah. Remembering Allah in your heart, to make a sincere intention that your deed is only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, إثار محاب الله تعالى على محاب العبد. You prefer what Allah loves and wants over what you love and you want. Okay? So you put Allah first before your own personal desires, and this will make you gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number five, مطالعة القلب لأسمائه وصفاته, that the heart always think and reflect in the names of Allah, the beautiful names of Allah, and also that you reflect on Allah's qualities, being As-Sabur, the most patient one, Al-Khabir, the one who is aware about all things, Al-Raqib, the one who is watching over everything. Okay? Number 6. التفكر في آلاء الله ونعمه الظاهرة والباطنة. Thinking and reflecting on the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His blessings and His gifts, the ones that the inward and the outward. There are certain things that we see and there are certain things that we don't see. As example, you understand, you thank Allah for your hand, that you're able to write, that you're able to eat with it. You don't see your heart, you don't see your lungs, okay? But you can thank Allah and reflecting about how Allah making this heart always bumping, even when you go to sleep. So reflecting on Allah, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the favor and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that is appearance and the one is hidden. Number 7, inkisarul qalbi lillahi ta'ala. You come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with humiliation. You come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a broken heart, feeling that you are lower, that Allah is high, that you are poor and Allah is the rich, that you are the weak and Allah is al-qawi. So to come to Allah with a broken heart, you don't come to Allah with arrogancy, that you know that you can, okay? But you always come to Allah with a broken heart, seeing your sins, acknowledging your weakness, acknowledging your faults, and you come to Allah in this way. Number 8, Al-Khulwa Billahi Waqtan Nuzul Al-Ilahi. Having privacy and seclusion with Allah, especially in the time when Allah comes down to the lowest heaven, that means in the last part of the night, that you have time to sit and to think, and to make dhikr, recite Quran in a special time towards the end of the night. So you have privacy, that you have a seclusion, you have a special time between you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 9, Mujalasatu Salihin, Al-Muhibbin Al-Sadiqin. Sitting with the truthful one, the one who loves Allah, and try to pick up and select their special terms and sentences and wisdom that they say. So you sit with the people of knowledge, you sit with the people who remember Allah, you sit with the people who visit the mosques, okay? And you always have to have your ear open to what they're saying, and they try to collect, like you go in a garden and you pick up the best fruit that you see. So also when you sit with the knowledgeable people, the people of wisdom, the people of Allah, that you pay attention to what they're saying and they try to learn from them and pay attention. Number 10, staying away from everything that it will prevent your heart from Allah. That in other words, stay away from being heedless. Any means and any reasons that cause your heart to be a distant from Allah, watching TV, movies, sitting with people they have nothing to talk about except dunya or gossiping. So selecting your environment. So all these things, if we try to work on them, it will make us among those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love. O Allah, we ask your love and the love of those who loves you and the love of those people who you love them. O Allah, we ask you that you make us love all the deeds that bring us closer to you. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. Thank you for watching. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.